the laws of scalability, Amdahl's law and Gunther's law, show us that linear scalability is almost always unachievable. Now, I want to demonstrate this with another particular real-world scenario, and that is the idea of the mythical man month. So if you haven't heard of the mythical man month, there's a book out there that you're welcome to look up. But what it talks about is the idea that if you have a late project, for example, a software project that you're working on, and that project is late, a common thing that people will do in order to bring a project back on schedule is they will add more people. The problem is, and what the mythical man month shows, is that adding more people doesn't necessarily speed up the project. In fact, it quite frequently makes a late project more late. And the reason it happens like that is actually because of the laws of scalability. So if you have a software project, you are going to have portions of that project that are parallelizable, but you will also have portions that are not. You'll have certain specialists within your application development cycle, and those specialists' jobs cannot simply be parallelized. Those people have to do that job. Nobody else can do it. And there's going to be other things too, other portions of the project that can't be parallelized. As a result, you're subject to Amdahl's law. You can add more people to the project and certain pieces of the project are parallelizable and will speed up. But for the pieces that aren't, you're not going to make any impact on them at all. And so you will see that diminishing return effect that you get from Amdahl's law. But in addition to that, when you add those additional people, suddenly you've got an additional communication burden that goes along with it. You have more work that has to be done to make sure that those people are doing their jobs, making sure that they're coordinating with the other people so that if they release a new feature or a new piece of that feature, that aligns with everybody else on the project. You've also got to deal with those people in meetings, scheduling them for meetings, making sure that their opinions are heard. So all of a sudden there's an additional communication burden that didn't exist before. And so you're now subject to Gunther's law as well. And so as a result, because of Amdahl's law and because of Gunther's law, adding more people to the project actually can make it slow down and can make a late project even worse. So both of these are showing us that linear scalability is almost always unachievable. Linear scalability requires total isolation. We basically need a system that's stateless. And when we talk about stateless, we don't mean stateless in the sense that the state is stored in the database. We mean truly stateless. There is no state. If we need to share state between members of our system, then we lose the ability to do linear scalability. Now, this gets tricky because even if we had a system that was truly stateless, we probably would need something like a load balancer or something like that in front of it. And that then becomes a shared resource as well. And so we get back to the point where we don't have total isolation anymore. It's very difficult or impossible to design a system that is truly stateless. Reactive systems understand the limitations that are imposed by these laws. We don't try to avoid these limitations, we accept them. And what we do instead is we try to minimize their impact. We try to exploit them rather than avoiding them. So how do we do that? Well, reactive systems are going to try to reduce contention, and they're going to do that by isolating locks. Again, if you have a large lock, then that creates a lot of contention, but an isolated lock creates less contention. If we can eliminate the lock completely, even better. We eliminate transactions. If we can eliminate transactions, that's one way that we can reduce contention on our database, for example. We avoid blocking operations. Blocking operations tie up things like memory and threads and CPU and various other things for some period of time. What we want to do is we want to release those resources so that they can be used by other things, thereby reducing contention. We mitigate coherency delays, and we do that by embracing eventual consistency. If we accept the fact that things take a certain amount of time, then when they take time due to coherency delay, we won't be surprised by it. But we also look to build in autonomy. If we have more autonomous systems, then we don't have to have that communication going back and forth all the time. And reducing that communication then reduces the amount of coherency delay that we have to deal with. So that allows us to avoid that problem as well. By avoiding contention and by avoiding coherency delay, it allows us to achieve higher scalability. The goal here is not to pretend that these problems don't exist, but rather to eliminate the things that prevent scalability. And that's what allows us to achieve high scalability in reactive systems.